Our fall camp previews continue now with quarterbacks coach Joe Daly. And, Joe, as we look at the talented and deep quarterback position, we'll begin with Josh Woodrum, third-year starter coming back. I know the push to him was to improve his accuracy coming up this fall. How has he looked so far?
I think he's done a phenomenal job of making the improvements that he needed and the ones that we recommended following 2013 season. We spent a lot of time talking about the different areas specific to accuracy that he needed to improve, and bit by bit, you know, past these past 5-6 months, he's really stepped up his game in the sense of trying to master them and get them to be where they need to be come game day.
You're a former quarterback. What are keys to improving accuracy?
Mostly it's knowing targets versus landmarks. If you know what your target is and you're consistent in it, trying to hit it, you're going to be more accurate because you're conscientious of where the ball location needs to be. And then obviously the landmarks on the football field, I'm specific about the numbers, the pylons, the uprights, the hash marks. And those guys know on certain throws, those are the targets or the landmarks, so to speak. Make sure that ball is in that location for a better percentage of completion.
And part of that equation, I would think too, Joe, is the wide receiver or that target you're throwing to. They have to be maybe not in the spot where you're throwing it, but they have to end up there when the ball is there. How important is that to figuring out better accuracy?
I mean, it's crucial. Everything that we do between the quarterback and receiver position is about timing, it's about rhythm, and it's about being at a certain landmark, a certain depth on the quarterback's third or fifth or seventh step. And we work constantly on being where you need to be when that quarterback puts his foot in the ground and bounces or bounces twice. And we spend every day, we spend a 5-minute period with the receivers just working on specific timing routes. And then we go to a routes versus air period where we're all on air and we're trying to hit targets and landmarks. And then we go to 7-on-7. So it's just a constant rehearsal of those landmarks and targets that gets us to be, you know, where we need to be come game day.
Starting quarterback position is always important, but there's always discussion on who number two is going to be, whether it be at Liberty or Notre Dame or Clemson. It doesn't matter. Here, you've got two capable guys, Stephon Mosha and Javon Shishetti. They've been working really hard. Javon obviously got reps last year. Stephon redshirted. So take me through that competition and where those guys are.
Well, we'll start with Javon Shishetti. He's done a phenomenal job of climbing the ladder from the spring going into the fall here. And he's made a lot of improvements just on his knowledge and awareness of all 11 people on offense and specifically all 11 on defense. So he makes a lot of great decisions despite only being, you know, a junior in the classroom, sophomore on the field. And he's done a phenomenal job in this fall camp of just being consistent. And that's all you can ask for that number two guy. He has to be consistent. And he has to be able to get you out of a game, you know, God forbid anything happens to the starter. And Javon has done a phenomenal job of proving himself that he's capable of doing that.
And how about Stephon Mosha? Finally got the red shirt off of him, and how has he looked in his first couple of reps?
Stephon's done a really good job himself of showing that he comprehends exactly what it is that we're trying to install and trying to execute here thus far in fall camp. Obviously has a special talent. He can throw that football a great ways with a lot of velocity, and he has some pretty good accuracy, but he also has a unique talent in the sense that he can run with the football as well, and that makes him very dynamic.
More likely, the new freshman in, JT Bradwell, is probably a redshirt candidate, not speaking for coach, but I would imagine with the depth where it is right now at that position. What is his role right now? And also touch on Bo Swanson, who will join you back here next week.
JT was specifically is trying to just become aware of exactly what it is that we're trying to accomplish here, you know, on offense here at Liberty. It's very, very complex. There's a lot of different pieces to this puzzle, and very few quarterbacks that can come into the system as a freshman and can be able to assemble the puzzle right away. And so we're working on specific pieces for him to master so that we can move on to the next, so on and so forth, so that come springtime, he'll be able to sort the puzzle together the way we want and kind of be able to operate, you know, at a high level.
And as we kind of wrap things up here, Joe, North Carolina, a play that's dear to your heart. You played football there. Have you started really thinking about what that game might mean for you guys in a couple of weeks?
I've had a bunch of conversations and text messages and emails from a bunch of friends, alumni, and a couple of folks that still work there to this day. And it's been all good fun. And I know I'm extremely excited to be going back home, so to speak. But I'm really focusing on getting, you know, my number one, two, and three guy ready for this game, because you never know when your number's going to be called. And so I got to make sure that I'm prepared to say X, Y, and Z is ready to go in the game if he needs to be.
All right, we can't wait for it, Joe. Thanks for the time.
No problem. Thank you so much.
That's quarterback's coach Joe Daly. I'm Alan York for the Liberty Flames Sports Network.